Hello, I'm Reema, and today I'll be teaching you Styajit Ray's Bhuto. So here we will see today that how mystery unfolds itself through the various covers of comedy, through the various covers of the normal daily life. We'll see in this particular story that it actually begins with a rather normal atmosphere, with a rather homely atmosphere, but by the end, as the plot complicates, we'll see that how it turns itself into a creepy mystery story that might give goosebumps. So, as you all can see, it's Bhuto. The story, the name is called Bhuto. And let me say you, Styajit Ray is a Bengali author. And if you take the very Bengali linguistics, Bhuto, the very word, comes from the mother word called Bhut, which do mean ghost. So the very name carries the connotation of mystery within itself. But however, in normal Bengali household, nicknames such as Bhuto are also been given to the boys as well as the girls. So here, looking at the name, we might get confused that whether it really contains something mysterious connotation or a very homely name, does it say, or does it want to imply. Anyways, the story begins with Naveen Munshi. Naveen Munshi, he's a young gun, obviously a college pass out, and from his profile we can make it out that he is more than just an average student, nothing like he's a topper, he is not again a very meritorious student, but yes, he has a passion. He has a passion for this extracurricular activities, such as which delves into the mystery stories, which delves into the mysterious arenas. For example, magic shows or say ventriloquism, etc., etc. Now in this story, we'll come to know that initially this Naveen Munshi, the protagonist, he was rather interested in magic. The particular word, the very name of this art, ventriloquism, was unknown to him. Only after a show in his hometown that he came to know that ventriloquism is an amazing and unique art, and after that he got himself attracted to this. Now, who was the maestro who has inspired Naveen Munshi for this art, knowingly or unknowingly, intentionally or unintentionally? That is the Arkur Babu. He is a ventriloquist maestro. He had a show at a small town called Uttarpara. Uttarpara is again the hometown of our protagonist Naveen Munshi. Now Naveen Munshi witnessed this show of Arkur Babu, and he simply found himself passionate about this particular art that is called ventriloquism. We might also see as the pages unfolds that Naveen Munshi, being a very average, mediocre student, the very name of this art, ventriloquism, the very pronunciation for it was also very much impossible for him. Initially, he couldn't even utter the word ventriloquism, and for the spelling, forget it, because he is a mediocre student. We have saying you repeatedly. Now, what is ventriloquism? In the second page of the story, it's described it in details that ventriloquism involves an artist who speaks for himself and also speaks for another imaginary character located somewhere there, or it's understood that the imaginary character is located somewhere up or down the stage. So this Arkur Babu, how was he conducting his show? He was asking some questions, some sort of question, especially the comical ones on the comical side, some sort of such questions to an imaginative artist or to an imaginative character upon the stage. So Arkur Babu, how he conducted the show? Upon the stage, he was standing there and he was simply looking upon the ceiling of the stage, and he was asking to an imaginative character, "Hello, how are you?" And that imaginative character would answer him back, "Hey, I am fine there. Why are you calling for me?" Now, this particular answer, which is supposed to come from that very imaginative personality was given by or was provided by Arkur Babu himself. How is Arkur Babu doing this? Hello, how are you? And without or hardly moving his lips, he was imitating the voice of that imaginary personality, and he was not trying to pronounce it in front of the audience so that the audience have this mistaken identity that someone else is speaking instead of Arkur Babu in a changed tonality of the voice. For example, here is you can see, if you look at the page, second page of the story, Arkur Babu is saying, have you become interested in music? Is it true? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The answer is coming from that imaginary voice. Classical music, Arkur Babu is asking. Yes, sir. Classical music. Arkur Babu once again asks, do you sing yourself? No, sir. Do you play an instrument? That's right, sir. What kind of instrument? The sitar. No, sir. Sarod. No, sir. What do you play then? A gramophone, sir. So you can understand the very comic nature of this particular dialogue or conversation that Arkur Babu is asking to his imaginary friend, that nowadays you have become interested in music, it seems, so you must be playing some kind of musical instrument, or you must be singing. So he is saying, no, I don't sing, neither do I play any authentic instrument. What this person plays, imaginary character, he plays a gramophone. And gramophone, if you go back to the very 1980s or 70s like that, you will see that gramophone were provided with records where you play the recorded music. So this imaginary friend was interested in music, that is interested in listening to the music, not playing the music by himself, by his own self. So that is how, where the comedy lies beneath the conversations in this, especially in this ventriloquism shows. Now, after watching this wonderful show, Naveen Munshi got attracted to it. And then what he decided that he will meet Arkur Babu personally in his own residential address, and he did that also. The first day he went there, he was simply being insulted by Arkur Babu. Arkur Babu was rather trying to be very humble and rather try to be very straightforward. He said that, see, I don't teach anyone, and I don't have any time for myself to teach you right now. So it's better that you leave. Please don't disturb me. Naveen Munshi went back disheartened, obviously, but he didn't left his hope. What he did, he once again, after some few weeks, he went again back to Arkur Babu's place. And once again, he requested, and this time Arkur Babu was really irritated. So what he replied back, that this art is not for all and sundry. So when you're saying someone that this art is not for all and sundry, it is implied that the person to whom you are talking, that person is otherwise a very common, mediocre person, and that person is not eligible for such a noble art. So Arkur Babu simply insulted him directly that Naveen Munshi was not a very noble personality to have knowledge about this particular art. Now Naveen Munshi, now his ego was hot. So he said that it's okay. If I have to learn this art by my own self, I will be learning by my own self. So what he did, he went from straight to the residence of Arkur Babu to call a street. Now if you know something about Calcutta, the modern name is Kolkata. If you go there, College Street is a place where you find numerous books. It's one of Asia's biggest book markets. So from there, he bought one of those books which teach the very art of ventriloquism. And he started, simply he devoted himself for this art, and he started practicing days and night tirelessly. He started this. And looking at his very devotion, his uncle, who is actually raising him up, he was also very much impressed. Then on a Sunday, on a fine day, after he has acquired all his skills, what he did, he made a homely show to his friends as well as to the uncle. Now, all his friends, all his families were very much impressed with Naveen Munshi's presentations. And therefore, out of this impression, out of this positive vibes, what Naveen Munshi's uncle did, he agreed to give him a puppet, the fund for making a puppet for this ventriloquism show. Now here I need to tell you something regarding the background of ventriloquism show. Ventriloquism, what it requires from the very artist, that hardly moving your lips, you talk or you chatter, I mean, repetitively and continuously. There, you just cannot touch your lips. Without touching your lips, you have to say these words. For example, you cannot say P, you have to say A. You cannot say F, you have to say A. You cannot say B, you have to say E. So B, for that, you require to touch your lips. But you will not be touching your lips, and rather you'll be saying E. For example, if you want to say boat, you cannot say boat, B-O-A-T, boat. B-O-A-T, boat, will never be pronounced as boat. How will it be pronounced? It will be pronounced as O-A-T, oat. Okay? So, and without moving or distancing your lips apart much, you will, if you pronounce oat, then it sounds like boat by the very, the audience receives it as boat. So that is the trick of ventriloquism. And Naveen Munshi actually acquired it nicely in his, all his veins. Now, there was a time to build a puppet as a prop for his ventriloquism show. Arkur Babu was an artist in this arena, or is still an artist in this arena. And he was rather an old-fashioned one. That is why he was, in his show, he was looking up at the ceiling and he was imitating someone else's voice too, in his own voice. But what Naveen Munshi did, he made a puppet for himself. So whatever questions he'll be throwing it, that he will be actually directing it to the puppet, and the puppet will be talking back to him. And when the puppet talks back, it's actually Naveen Munshi who talks. Okay. So, here comes the scene that Naveen Munshi really wants to take a revenge upon this maestro Arkur Babu because all of his insults. So, what Naveen Munshi did, he made the puppet a look-alike of Arkur Babu. So, the puppet actually appeared like, the puppet sported a pair of deep black bushy moustache, then jet black hair par in the middle, rippled down to the shoulders, then the eyes were droopy. The puppet was similarly made as a look-alike of Arkur Babu, the maestro. So, in this way, what Naveen Munshi wanted to suggest, that initially, Arkur Babu made Naveen Munshi a puppet in his own hands. And now Naveen Munshi is trying to make Arkur Babu a puppet in his own hands. So, that is how he wants to materialize his revenge. So, aftermath starts Naveen Munshi's show. And as you unfold the pages of the story, you see that Naveen Munshi gradually acquires the fame to such a level that he becomes a celebrity ventriloquist artist who initially had the problem even of pronouncing or spelling the very word of ventriloquism. Now what happens, that Bhuto, he names the puppet as Bhuto. We should also remember that Bhuto is a look-alike of Arkur Babu, the previous maestro. Now, Naveen Munshi was going here and there for his shows, and he simply, out of his professional demands, could not stay back in this Uttarpara, a small hometown where actually he belongs to. So, he has rented one house in Calcutta, and from Calcutta, he was conducting his various other shows, and he was obviously played lump sum. Now, he had a very definite intuition that this Arkur Babu might someday come to his own show, and then he actually wants to present the very revenge to Arkur Babu practically. But what happened, to his very amazement, one fine day as he was returning back, like he returned back to his own house, rented house, he saw someone waiting for him. And that was none other than Arkur Babu. Now, he was again amazed because he thought that now his revenge might actually get realized. But what this Arkur Babu said, the conversation between them was obviously not a very jovial one. It was otherwise a very dry one, a threatening one. Arkur Babu initially said that, yes, you have actually jumped quite a greater leap for your own career. But you should also remember that you should not exploit someone else's name for your own fame, for your own achievements. Now, Arkur Babu intended to say that you made the puppet is my look-alike. But see, as you have made the puppet as my look-alike, I just cannot allow you to do that because you're simply humiliating me on the public. He even reported that he had a show in Barasat. Another place nearby Kolkata, and when he went upon the stage, he received catcalls. When he went upon the stage, the public started calling him Bhuto, Bhuto from the various other corners of this hall. So he was simply humiliated in the public eye, and it is also implied that his income, his earnings, his fame has actually demolished his Naveen Munshi's career graph was increasing or it was elevating. So at that point of time, what happened? That he simply threatened Naveen Munshi by saying such words that apart from ventriloquism, I am also well versed in some other forms of arts which I was being taught by one sage from the Himalayas. But I have promised to my very guru that I will actually not show these arts upon the stage, in front of the public eye. I will never showcase them to earn money. So that is what Arkur Babu has said, and Naveen Munshi was simply numb at that time. He was simply mute. He didn't give any response, but he was thinking at this time that what might be that Arkur Babu was intending while he was saying that he knows few other forms of arts too, few mysterious forms of arts. And as Arkur Babu was departing, he was saying that he mentioned few changes in Bhuto's appearance, in the puppet's appearance. So Arkur Babu, we know that he threatened Naveen Munshi indirectly by saying all such informations regarding him. And as he was leaving, upon a sweet note, what he said, that say, my hairs have turned grey, like it's gradually turning grey as I am getting old. So I see that you have made your puppet in the similar manner, because I see some few grey strands of hair in your puppet too. And Naveen Munshi at that point of time was otherwise surprised, because he remembers that when he ordered for this puppet, he never had mentioned to put any grey strands of hair in his puppet. But as after Arkur Babu left on that very night, what he had seen, he had observed that his puppet Bhuto actually developed some few grey strands of hair upon itself. Now he was otherwise amazed. He rushed back to the place and to the person who actually made this puppet for him. His name is Adinath Pal, and to Adinath Pal he inquired that when you were making this puppet for me, have you ever had put any grey strands of hair? He said that no, I have never, but these are prominent now. It must be out of mistake, and you better see that what's wrong with it. You might have enemies. Now you have gone to celebrity level, so a few of your enemies might have done this for you. And Naveen Munshi was otherwise convinced with this particular idea that yes, it must be his rival parties that must have put this grey hairs upon his puppet. However, he then became nonchalant about it. And there was another show after that day by Naveen Munshi. And as he returned from that show that night in his own room, in his own chamber, he put his puppet beside a lamp and he was trying to inspect upon it very carefully. And what he had seen, that a particular mole upon the forehead, a very small but a prominent one, has developed on Bhuto's face, Bhuto's forehead, which he also had noticed in Arkur Babu the other day when he came to his chamber. Now he was more than amazed, and more surprises were waiting for him, as he had noticed there were deep dark circles, rings of dark circles underneath Bhuto's eyes, which he also had noticed in Arkur Babu's facial expression. This point of time, Naveen Munshi was otherwise convinced of the mysterious arts that Arkur Babu had acquired. He thought that some kind of voodoo must have been played by Arkur Babu upon this particular puppet. Now, next, what he did, that he couldn't do anything. No remedy was there upon his mind for this particular problem. The next time, once again, he went to the show with that particular kind of a puppet who developed dark circles, rings of dark circles underneath his eyes with a mole upon the forehead. He went to another show. And on that show, the very conversation, the very dialogue, he had already scripted. Now, what was the very dialogue? The very dialogue was that he was about to ask Bhuto, let's see, Nowadays, Calcutta is so hot, but how good it is for you. You don't perspire and sweat. And as he was trying to, or he was going to ask this particular question to Bhuto, suddenly, involuntarily, few words slipped out of his mouth as, why on earth all these things are happening, Bhuto? And out of his own surprise and amazement, what words came out from his own mouth, that is again involuntarily, karwa karwa, K-A-R-W-A, karwa karwa. Now we know in ventriloquism, you just cannot touch your lips. So instead of W, if you put M, it becomes karma. So Bhuto was actually trying to pronounce the word karma from Naveen Munshi's mouth. And what is the meaning of this very karma? Karma is again has got a religious connotation. It says in the Gita that whatever your work are, actually they are already paid in the future. So karma is actually your work, your duties, your responsibilities which you perform on this earth. So whatever you are playing now, today you have to pay for that. If you are doing a very good job, you will be paid in credits. But if you are not doing a very good job, if you are exploiting someone, then you will be simply debited out of your luck. So that is what this karma of Naveen Munshi, that is he has humiliated our Kurbabu, this is now paying for him. Because all these dialogues were not suggested in the very script. And at this time, involuntarily such words are coming out. And obviously that show simply turned out to be a flop show. Because no philosophic, direct philosophic conversation is required in a ventriloquism show. But over here, in this particular instance, they actually talked about some direct philosophic dialogues. So that was a flop show, flop ventriloquism show. And Naveen Munshi retired back to his own house, disheartened, denied and rejected, feeling dejected. And on that particular day, what had happened was a very, that we can attest that it was the very last day of Bhuto as well as Naveen Munshi's fame perhaps. Because on that particular day, he had noticed, or rather night I will say, he had noticed that after his dinner, Bhuto was suddenly trying to breathe out loud as if someone has congested its lungs. A very deep, distinct sound of breathing, long deep breathings was coming from Bhuto, and he was simply at that time feeling the goosebumps. He was haunted by this. And at around midnight, what he had seen, that the very parts of Bhuto is a puppet which is otherwise flexible, it's kind of a soft toy, so you can move its hands, its legs, its head. But by midnight, suddenly the entire body of Bhuto jammed. And what happened after that? That Naveen Munshi tried to twist its head from here in this direction to the other direction, 180 degree. As he was trying to do it, its head fell off to the ground. It became as solid and brittle as it happens to a dead body after a certain period of time if you were keeping it. Now, on the next morning, the news was that the maestro Arkur Babu has left the earth. So therefore, it can be Naveen Munshi could actually relate that with the death of Arkur Babu, his Bhuto is also dead. Arkur Babu was simply transplanted onto Bhuto and he simply took back Bhuto with himself from this earthly mundane earth. So now Naveen Munshi is left with is nothing, not his Bhuto, not his ventriloquism medium. So therefore we can understand that from a very homely and a very calm atmosphere, how mystery can unfold in the various facets of life. Thank you.